Simon says subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive notifications.
In this next set of lessons, we are going to be discussing the various types of selection tools available in Photoshop. Now, if we look in the upper left, you can see here, I have these four different selection tools. We have our basic selection of selecting the whole image. We have selecting parts of the image using the Marquee tool and the Lasso tools and also the Quick Selection, and our Magic Wand tools, which we'll be looking at in future videos. Now, if we right-click on the Marquee tool, you're going to see that we have a variety of different types of Marquee tools, and we're going to be focusing on the rectangular one and the elliptical one. Now, the first thing I'm going to do before I even get started is I'm going to unlock this layer so I can have a little more flexibility with what I can do with it. Now, when we use these tools, essentially, we are just selecting part of the image so we can do things to it. So maybe it's as simple as deleting part of the image. It could be copying to be able to paste it someplace else. Maybe you're going to fill it in with color. You can do all kinds of different things with just some basic selection. So let's say, for example, I do not want to have this kind of top gray part of my image here. So I can just simply highlight it, and now that is active. So all I need to do is hit the delete key on my keyboard, and that is gone. And you can see now, judging from the checkerboard in the background, that is now transparent. So for whatever's going to be behind this image in another layer, that would show through, or there would be nothing there at all. Okay, now, once you have something selected, it's a very good idea to deselect it. So a couple of ways you can do that. Number one is just a very simple right click, and you can see here is deselect. I can do that. I'm going to go and undo that by doing Control or Command Z. And there's another way that I like, which is the keyboard shortcut of Control or Command D for deselect. I use that one all the time. Good idea to always deselect whenever you're done selecting, because then Photoshop won't get confused and think you still want that to be an active part of your image to be able to do something to it. Okay, so I'm going to go and undo one more time, bring that all the way back, and then I'm going to go ahead and deselect. Now let's take a look at another way that we could be using the Marquee tool. So I'm going to draw out a perfect square by holding down the Shift key, because maybe I want to have this little bit of this image selected. And notice I can also move it around, and I really like that. And I want to have this on another document altogether. So basically I'm going to copy it and then paste it someplace else, keeping this one preserved. So very simply I can go to Edit and then Copy. And then I'm going to go to File and then New. And then I'm going to say Create. And now I have an empty canvas waiting for me to then paste that image in there. Okay, so now I have pretty much a close-up of this image. I didn't have to crop anything like that. And I now have this image while this original image is still preserved. Let's come back to the original image. I'm going to hit Control D, deselect it. And now let's go ahead and do the elliptical Marquee tool. I'm going to hold down the Shift key to make a perfect circle. But this time I'm going to do something kind of fun. I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to say select the inverse. And now the outside is selected. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the delete key. And what's going to happen when I hit the delete key, it's going to delete everything but the middle of the image because I selected the inverse selection. Nice little trick there. So I hit the delete key and now I have this beautiful image right there. And I'm going to go ahead and just do Command or Control D. And I have this as my image in a pretty neat way, right? Where you can have a nice little circle, a perfect circle, framing my image just like that. Okay, and I'll show you one nice little trick here to get rid of all these extra transparent pixels. If you go over here to Image and then you say Trim, you can see here it's going to trim all the transparent pixels, the top, bottom, left, and right. I click OK, and now I have exactly the image I want. Okay, so lots you can do with such a simple tool. So please go ahead, pause the video, practice that, and we'll see you in the next lesson.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.